A while back, I had to preach a really, really difficult funeral for a man that was a friend of mine that attended the church that I attend. His family was really tore up because he died of COVID. He was on a ventilator, and they really didn't feel like they were able to say goodbye. It was a very, very difficult situation. They asked me to officiate the funeral. I said yes, but I didn't know exactly how I was going to do it. But God showed me a way. And this way that God showed me, hopefully it's something that you can do too that will help you when you are officiating a funeral. It was sadness, it was sorrow, and it was mourning. What was I going to say to this family to make them feel better? I was thinking about it, I was praying about it, and God brought this to my mind. My friend was very active on Facebook, and I said, what better way to speak at a funeral than to let him himself speak at this funeral? And I went through his timeline or his thread on Facebook, and I took out all the funny things that he said. I took out all the things that he cared about. I read through them and I put them in order, and I stood back and I looked at his personality and who he was, and I put those traits and attributes about him in order, and then I took the Facebook post that related to those things and I put them there, and I would say something about him. I would read a Facebook post, and I'm gonna tell you what, it was a reaction like no other I'd ever had at a funeral. It did help, okay, that I was friends with this man. I'd been friends with him for 4 or 5 years. I had visited with him. I knew a lot about him. But this Facebook post deal and me knowing his attributes really helped out at the funeral. His wife was sitting on the front row, and when she gets really tickled, she even snorts. And guess what? She snorted at the funeral. And you may say, well, Chaplain Reece, this person, I wasn't very close to him. Well, what you need to do is you need to talk to their family member and get a notepad and say, hey, what were the attributes about this person? What are some stories? And if they've got a Facebook page, look it up and see what kind of things that they posted. My friend, he even posted a little joke and put on there, and I read that. It brings that person to the moment. Even though they're gone, it brings them there, and it was so powerful. I told his acts of kindness. I told the things that he was interested in, the things that he did for me. He loved going shopping. He loved sales. And he would call me and text me when things were on sale because I got a big family and he knows that money's tight. I brought that up at the funeral, and everyone felt comforted hearing about him.
Hey there, this is Chaplain Reece. I forgot to mention that after I expressed all of these things, personal things about my friend, then I presented the gospel. And the way that I presented the gospel, I have made a video on how I officiate a funeral, and I will list it in a card up here at the top. You can watch it, and it shows the entire outline of the presentation of the gospel.
I even had a sales paper. That morning before the funeral, I looked down and there was a sales paper in the floor that came from one of the grocery stores that he shopped at. I even took it to the funeral and held it up and told the story of how I was sitting there at 5 o'clock in the morning. I looked down, I seen it, and I thought of him. Now, I don't get to do this with a lot of funerals because a lot of funerals I preach, I just know the person a week, I've met them once, or I've never met them at all. This was a great time to take an opportunity to bring comfort and peace to a family that really needed it. I hope this has helped. My name's Chaplain Reece. Don't forget to read your Bible and pray every day. Don't forget I love you and appreciate you. If you have not already, I want to encourage you to subscribe to my channel so you don't miss the next video where I encourage you to live by faith through Jesus Christ and by the power of the Holy Ghost.